What is up, weather enthusiasts? I'm your host, Pat's Path Predictor. Let's get right into the weather. All right, so here's the situation we have for you, ladies and gentlemen. We have this one area of interest right here. The other two have been dropped by the NHC since yesterday. Here's what we got. Here are the cliff notes. 30% chance of formation in the next 7 days, up from 20% yesterday. A tropical wave is located a couple hundred miles to the southwest of the Cabo Verde Islands. Conditions are expected to be favorable for gradual development of the system later this week and into the weekend, while it moves west to west-northwestward over the tropical Atlantic. Formation chance in the next 2 days is 0%, 30% in the next 7 days. This is the main area where this is going to be developing. As I've been looking at many model runs and everything like that, conditions improve considerably once they get over here, and we'll get to those in just a second. But before we get to that, we go ahead and give you a quick overview of what's going on in the Atlantic. Right now in the Atlantic, we have these two former areas of interest, Invest 95L and this one that is currently producing a ton of rain over about a little northeast of the Bahamas right there. Potentially Florida could get impacted by some rain with this. Same with Georgia and the Carolinas, something to monitor as a flooding threat if you're in the local areas right there. 95L, formerly 95L, I'm not really paying any more attention to. This will be the last kind of thing we talk about. It's just producing a lot of heavy rain in the Caribbean. Shear's going to tear it apart pretty quickly, so we'll have to kind of close that chapter and then open a new one with this area of interest that we're looking at right here. Because what I've been looking at, the latest GFS runs continue to be very interesting, to say at the very least. And keep in mind, before I show you these, I'm taking these with a huge grain of salt, considering how far out these go. Now, we're going to go ahead and take a look at this. And as you can see, it starts organizing, developing, and then it starts turning and basically stays out to sea. Doesn't really impact any land compared to what I've been seeing with the runs yesterday. And this is about 9 days out by the time it gets over here. And by the time it potentially strengthens into a hurricane, it's about 6 days out. So in order for this thing to really get to where it is according to the GFS, it would have to get over to the spot that it's potentially developing at and then develop at a pretty quick pace and then organize and then strengthen at a pretty rapid pace as well, which, again, isn't completely unfeasible. But it is tricky considering if the system organizes, considering how the shear is doing. And we'll show you all the dynamics behind it in just a second. But that I'm just showing you what the latest GFS is showing, just to kind of give you my thoughts on all this. Because right now I'm taking it with a grain of salt, especially compared to where we were yesterday, where we were having runs of this potentially hitting the Bahamas, moving across the East Coast, hitting potentially the Carolinas right there before moving out into Canada, barely passing Newfoundland right there. That's what the 18Z GFS had yesterday. Now the last three runs basically have the same thing, where it basically completely stays out to sea like this with varying strength right here and varying speed as well. So am I inclined to trust any of these runs? Not yet. I'm going to have to wait and see until it gets into this area of interest, of this area of development right here, to figure out what's going on, because it's still very early in its life cycle. But here's what's working for it. Very warm global sea temperatures, 30 degrees Celsius across much of the Atlantic. Where this thing's going to be at, it's going to be around 28, 29 degrees Celsius, but still rocket fuel no matter what. And the OHC, where this is going to be at, about 100, maybe as high as 125 OHC by the time it gets there, which already pretty large amount of fuel going into this. And compared to where we were in 2020, if this was going in the same place about 3 years ago, it would not have nearly as much energy to work off of, around 50 OHC or so, which if then you have 100 already in a lot of these areas right now where this thing's going, a lot more ground to work with, a lot more fuel to work with. One thing we need to take a look at, though, the big question we have right here is how strong the shear will be. And right now where this is, the shear is pretty unfavorable. Where this is expected to meander, the shear is quite unfavorable right now. But right now is right now. And even though we're seeing like 30 to 40 knots or so in the area where it's supposed to go right now, that's not going to last forever. And we have these model runs to prove it right here. We're going to go ahead and show you the European. As you can see, this is the 0Z European. This is the latest from the shear we have. pretty much unfavorable in parts of the Atlantic where this thing is going to be heading. However, take a closer look. We're going to go ahead and start about 24 hours out. Not that much change. We're going to go ahead and go to 48 hours. You start to see quite a bit of a change. You start seeing the wind shear in this area right here decrease by a considerable rate. And then we'll go out to 72 hours. And it's still about the same as it was 48 hours out, but it's starting to fluctuate a bit. Then about 4 days out, continuing to fluctuate, but basically by the time this approaches there, the wind shear absolutely just starts collapsing right there. This wind shear by about 162 hours out pretty much collapses where this thing's going to be, and it's going to be moving through much more favorable shear for this thing to potentially develop. Now the question is, will there be enough moist air for this thing to support itself? Because a bit of dry air that gets into the system is not going to go very well. And the question is answer's a bit mixed right now. There is that moist pocket that's going to be working off of, but it's surrounded with dry air until it gets out there, when the dry air does start to calm down a bit here. But then we see a resurgence of Sahara dust right here. That could potentially cause some problems if it's moving out this way. Now, if it pushes out a little bit this way, depending on how it executes that, it wouldn't have too many problems. But my big issue is with all the Sahara dust that's going on right here in the Atlantic, it may end up just hampering its development like it has been doing so far and kind of keeping that last line of defense. Now, I want to go ahead and see what the GFS is saying about the Sahara dust, because what the GFS has is the Sahara dust is much less than what the European is calling for, which if that is the case, then this system's going to have no problem strengthening, organizing, especially with the amount of shear that's going to be in the area. But right now, it's going to depend on how much dust and how much dry air there is going to be surrounding this, because if the European is more accurate, I don't see that much of an opportunity unless it goes up north. Now, if it were the GFS and we're seeing this and taking this at face value, then I'd say no matter what, it's going to develop. We're going to have to wait and see. There's a lot of uncertainty. Now we're going to go ahead and show the ensemble runs to see how much this uncertainty is. And the European ensemble kind of has this thing staying out to sea. We have a couple of areas strengthening up to hurricane strength right there, but once again, that Sahara dust could potentially hamper that effort right there. So that's the latest from the European ensemble. We do have some increasing activity up here, probably some subtropical stuff going on, but pretty much until the second week of August, the European ensembles don't have too much going on, but that's also going to be when the Sahara dust is going to start weakening. Now we're going to go ahead and show you the GFS ensembles, and the GFS ensembles have been going off on a limb. They have a massive amount of stuff that's going on, like a massive amount of hurricane scenarios right there, mainly staying out to sea. A couple of them have it potentially impacting land, potentially impacting the Lesser Antilles with a little bit of wind, a little bit of surge with the outer bands, but other than that, nothing too out of the ordinary right there. And the GPS ensembles, we're going to go ahead and show you those as well. And those aren't showing very many scenarios of strong systems similar to the European. It's more in agreement with the European system, although development is absolutely possible with this new area of interest right here. We'll have to keep you updated here on the Pat's Path Predictor channel. We're going to go ahead and close the video out right here. I hope you enjoyed it. Be sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you are new. It helps us out, helps us make more videos like these. The goal of this channel is to get more people engaged with weather. If you want to come hang out with us at Storms United and you want to see some of the behind the scenes of what we do and our weather forecasts, as well as what we're thinking with tropical weather, especially with the hurricane season starting to get more active, feel free to join our Discord server. Link is right over there. But with that being said, have a wonderful day, guys. Stay safe.